Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel CrackGate Online. So in this video I will deal with sprinkler irrigation system. So both theoretical as well as numerical part I am going to deal. So let's start. This is about me. So what is the sprinkler irrigation system and what is its characteristics? So by this picture and this picture, what you can tell about the sprinkler irrigation system. So in this system, as you can see, there are pipes, there are some nozzles, and how the water is applying over the crop surface. So you can say it is applying in the form of rainfall, or how the natural rainfall happens. So first point, you can say this. Second point, water is flowing through pipes. Third point, water is coming through some nozzles and it is breaking up, so it is coming in form of droplets. Okay, so same points I have given for your reference. So water is coming in form of natural rainfall and it is using pipe and pump system, and the water is coming in form of droplets. So it is breaking up and coming in droplets form. And lastly, the entire system you have to design in such a way that the uniformity of water application can be maintained. There should be no flooding. So it is important to note that your application rate of sprinkler should always be lesser than the infiltration capacity of soil. Then only whatever amount you are applying, that will be absorbed by the soil. Okay, so it is clear in terms of basics. Now we will see the suitability of sprinkler system. So for which type of crops it is suitable? So you can remember that it is not suitable for delicate or tender crops. Rather, it can be used for any cropping system, and also it is used for tree crops. Okay, and what are the various slopes where it can be used? So in terms of slope, it is applicable in every slope. Means that slope is such type of slopes where you can perform the agricultural operation. It should not be like your hilly area, but it must be farmable slope where you can perform the agriculture, whether it is uniform or undulating. And you please remember that lateral pipes, what is this lateral pipe? I will show you in upcoming slides, but for now you remember, you have to place your lateral pipes in contours of the field where you are applying this irrigation system. What is contour? Contour is the area or the points of equal elevation. So if you are placing this lateral in contour point, then your pressure fluctuation will be minimum. And as you already know, the pressure has various effect on the droplet size, application rate, discharge. So it will affect your performance of system. So that's why it is important. Now, what is the suitable soil? So the soil should be of sufficient infiltration capacity. So if you are using it clay soil, so clay soil has very slow infiltration rate, although it has high moisture holding capacity, but infiltration rate is slow. So you have to decide your sprinkler system based on the soil condition. Okay, and what are the suitable irrigation water? So you can simply say that water should be clean, it should not be there, dirt should not be there. So that if dirt is there, what will happen? It will simply block your nozzles. So these are the various conditions where you have to use the sprinkler system. So now let's see the layout. So you can see these are the main component of irrigation system of sprinkler. So you have one water source from where you will pump this water. So in irrigations, this irrigation centrifugal pump is the major type of pump which is used. And then through the pipe system, this pipe is known as the main pipe. So what is main pipe? If you want to define, the main pipe is that pipe which receives water from the pump. And the pipes which receives water from the main pipe is known as the lateral pipe. So these two are receiving water from main pipe, so it is lateral pipe. Okay, then what is this one? This one, this is known as the riser. And what is this one? This is your spraying unit, or it is nozzle. So finally water is coming out from this nozzle. Okay, and if you will see the more detailed form, then at this point you will get some strainer, so that dust and mud can be managed. Here you will get one pressure indicator unit. Here you will get some gate to block the water. So like this, if you will go in detail, then many other components will also come, but in simplest form, this is the main component. So here pumping unit, main line, lateral and a sprinkler. Okay, I hope now this you can know as the basic layout of sprinkler irrigation system. Okay, so as I told, a close look you can see from pumping unit to main pipe. So all these are the lateral pipes. Okay, so if anybody ask you that one lateral is required for each row, okay, so is this statement true? So from this figure you can say this statement is not true. So for each and every plant this lateral pipe is not required, but in case of drip irrigation you need drip for each and every plant. So this is one difference. And as I told that you need screen filter, you need control valve, so you can go through this figure. Okay, so now this I want to show you. Suppose you saw the figure of this sprinkler system. Now water is coming out from this nozzle. Then what is the wetted area? How this water which is coming out from this sprinkler is affecting the soil? So if you will see the top face, so in actual condition it will not be pure circle, but it forms a circular wetting pattern. And if you will see from side face, so inside the soil it will look like something this. So your plant will be somewhere here and the plant root will be going like this. So your plant can absorb this water. Okay, and see this figure. So what is this? This is sprinkler 11, this is sprinkler 12. So this is the spacing between sprinkler along the lateral. So this L1 is lateral 1, this L2 is lateral 2. So this will be your spacing between laterals. Okay, and this is the main line. So from main line your laterals will be going. So this is distance between two sprinklers. Okay, and this is distance between two laterals. So see, each sprinkler is forming one circular pattern. So this sprinkler is also forming a circular pattern, so that your entire area should be irrigated, no area should left behind. So here it is shown as sprinkler spacing, and here it is shown as lateral spacing, whatever I told you. So I hope it is clear. So let's see what is the discharge of an individual sprinkler. So how you will calculate discharge for individual sprinkler? So I am concerned about calculating discharge of this sprinkler only, individual. So you have to, how you will calculate? You will take this spacing, lateral spacing, into sprinkler spacing, into application rate of this sprinkler. So this will give you the discharge rate. How? This unit is suppose meter, meter, and meter per hour. So what you got? Meter cube per hour. So in irrigation, you have to be very specific about the unit. If you can also play around the unit, you don't need to remember the formula. So for your reference, only I have given formula, but I will show you one numerical question in which you don't need to remember any of this formula. Whatever I told you, you remember this figure into your mind. And if in the exam also you are writing, then you can simply write this formula in terms of unit. Nobody will question your formula. Okay, this 360, nothing you need to remember. So let's see one numerical problem based on this. So we will solve this numerical problem. So what it is asking? It is asking the required capacity of a sprinkler. So please mind, this is discharge for individual sprinkler, means only for one. And if I am saying the discharge for this entire system, how much discharge it is giving me. So what I have to do? I have to multiply this quantity by total number of sprinkler. So if suppose 10 sprinklers are there, then multiply this by 10. So let's see this question. Here it is asking about the sprinkler capacity only. What it has given? It has given 16 sprinkler are spaced 12 meter on each line. Okay, so two lines are there. So 12 meter is this distance, spacing between line is 18, this is 18, and this between two sprinkler is 12. So what I told you, the spacing between sprinkler into spacing between lines multiplied by discharge rate, that is 1.25, and any efficiency has been given? No efficiency has been given. So it is asking entire sprinkler system. So what is the number of sprinkler? It is 16 sprinkler on one line. So how many lines are there? This is two lines, so multiplied by 2. So in one line your answer is completed. And please check the unit for this. This is in meter and this is in centimeter per hour. So divided by 100 and your answer will come in meter cube per hour. Now you can convert this meter cube per hour into liter per second or any other unit you want. So the same formula I applied without writing the formula. So you have to understand with this figure what are the various parameter has been given in question, and based on that you have to solve the problems. Okay, so I hope this numerical problem is clear. In next video also I will take one more numerical problem so that this entire sprinkler system will be covered. So in this video we saw the basic of sprinkler layout and the discharge capacity of nozzle. So in next video one more numerical problem and this topic will be over. So thank you for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe.